what we're going to do, the Star Spangled Banner. I want everyone to please rise as we get ready for Mr. D-Dubb.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail as the starlight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, brought truth to the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner it wave for the land of the brave and the home of the brave?
Yeah. Mr. D-Dubb, stay right with us.
What's up, everybody? Yes, I am the Action Man here at the New York State Arts Bank in Fort Plain, New York. Yes, it's not Fort Ba-Ba-Ba, New York. It's Fort Plain. And you know something? It's an amazing space, New York State Arts Bank. We actually repurposed an amazing bank venue into an art space.
We did.
Did you have a good time?
Oh, awesome time. I love coming here.
Thank you. And you know something? You have an amazing business. And I think it's really not only incredible as an application, but it can help other equestrian horse owners in the world. And this is the Happy Horse Forecast. So I'm going to do it in a nutshell for the novice. Basically, what it is an application for horse owners that enable them to know and forecast the weather so that they can actually adjust their conditions for the horses to protect them.
Right.
Please add.
Blankets, if you have rain coming and you need to prevent rain rot, and you need to look up the weather where the horse is located. So it all came up because I was looking up the weather. I'm 3 miles out of town, and I get Fort Plain weather. It's not my weather. So I have it so that you can put the actual address where the horse is. And then the bonus is you get the weather, and then the blankets here, blanket icon changes colors according to which blanket is recommended.
It's
and then you
cool.
can click on it if you don't know. I do now, but I didn't in the beginning. So that's for the beginner or not. And it'll tell you which blanket is suggested to be used. Like you can see here, it changes the temperature. So then it's a turnout blanket instead of a warm blanket. We don't have most of the warm blankets right now because the weather is summertime. But you have rain rot to prevent. You have mosquitoes and flies to keep them from biting. And then in the winter, the warmth. I'm from California. So out here when it gets 10 below, I want to make sure I know it's going to be 10 below and I put the right blanket on my horse.
Well, it's amazingly simple. And let's talk about the biggest thing. What's the cost for the end user?
$19.99 a year.
Which
for
is
the
nothing.
Beta phase. Yeah, it
that's
is
like
nothing.
Not even like $1.75 a month.
Yeah, it is actually. It's like $1.63
well,
or something.
That's incredible. And you're hoping your business model is to get hundreds of thousands of equestrian business owners the application.
Yes, and so I can take also a portion of the profits to start not only my own rescue, but in the meantime, every year, a portion of the profits will go to a local or a verified rescue, not local necessarily. This year it'll be local, but Peaceful Acres Horses is going to. But it will be benefiting the horses as well because I want to start my rescue, and I just came up with the idea. So
well, it's not only a great
it's
idea,
pretty good.
It's a fantastic idea, but
thank
now
you.
It's patented.
Yes.
It's protected, and it's proprietary. You like that? Three P's of a great business plan.
P-P-P.
So here's the bottom line. How do people go and find the application? That's the key.
They can go to the website at happyhorseforecast.com. And in the bottom of every page is the Google Store and the Apple Store. And you download it for free from there, and then it'll have you register. You can also look it up in the Apple Store and the Google Store.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
And when is it going to go live?
It should be next week.
Well, this is great because we have a great area of promotion here with the MNN Network because a lot of
these
guys that are incredibly fortified with their businesses also are equestrian lovers.
Yes.
And have businesses in the Hamptons, Saratoga Springs. They own racehorses. So this could be an amazing thing. You get like Belmont Racetrack that wants this. This could be fantastic.
Yeah,
so,
wait for phase two, too, where you can adjust it for your personal horse if it's clipped or older.
I love it. I'm still in phase one right
now.
Yeah,
this is phase one.
I'm sure there's many phases. It's great. So once again, how do people reach you?
HappyHorseForecast.com.
That's it.
Just like that. HappyHorseForecast.com.
And this is Alan Action saying thanks for being with me here at the New York State Arts Bank celebrating my birthday. It was great having you.
Happy birthday.
Thank you. It was great to have you, and you brought some great people.
It was great to be here. Thank you. It was fun. We had a great time.
And I really liked the music selection.
It was great. Oh, my gosh. Yeah, some of your artists, I love them. I can't wait to see them tour.
Guess what? Stadium tour coming to you soon. And you know something? She's going to be a big sponsor of ours because we're only going to reach more households that have equestrian loves and also equestrian business models.
And you're a nonprofit, so you
will
get some benefits.
I am a nonprofit, the New York State Arts Bank. And you know something? We're doing great things with great people. Mm-hmm. Thanks for being with me. And have a great and blessed day. So on this day, let's light the candles this evening. I want to thank you all for sharing my birthday with me. God bless you, and God bless America. Amen. I'm going to make a big wish. One, two, three. Thank you. All right. Now. Most incredible venue. This is the New York State Arts Bank with one of our contributor artists. Her name is Jenny Yip. Jenny, thank you for being with me.
You're very welcome.
Thank you for celebrating my birthday with me. It's always great to have beautiful people that have beautiful art to offer the bank.
You're very welcome and happy birthday, Alan. Yes, we're all happy to celebrate your birthday with you today.
Thank you.
And a big birthday, too.
I appreciate it. And you know something, talking about a significant time, you made a significant piece of historic art, which was constructed from a known piece of, actually not a known piece, a known photograph, which you actually painted. Explain what you did in the artistic world to make this happen.
Yes, exactly. A painting from the photograph. There is an existing painting a while ago. So this is a rendition of the portrait that Alan commissioned me to do. He wanted just like this, with a smile. So my rendition has a little smile compared to the original one. This is done on gouache paints with some color pencils on Bristol paper.
Well, you did an amazing job. And the reason why my initiative was to have him smile was because we worked so hard to get him into the Hall of Fame. Now he's smiling upon us.
Yes. Oh, that's a great
message. You like that? And this is very important. And I'm glad I brought that to you. Now, talk to me, because we're going to talk about Bud Fowler real quick. You know, he overcame some amazing obstacles to play baseball, to cut through the color barrier, and to do amazing things in baseball, and he overcame a lot of hatred and hostility. In your career, developing as an artist, what is your greatest overcoming factor that you overcame to be a successful artist?
I would say it isn't as challenging for me as for Bud Fowler, because he is back during the time of 1897, around that
time.
So we're now in the 21st century. Although I would say when I first started out, there were a lot more Caucasian artists. And so as an Asian artist, it was more popular at that time, a lot of the Caucasian artists. And I might have been overlooked, even though I have more skill sets and also do more quality work. But since then, times have changed. And
you've really overcome the obstacle of, like you said, the mainstream art, to contribute as an Asian artist, an amazing black athletic icon. So on that note, I would like to tell you two things. One, thank you for making this. And two, thank you for understanding the significance of this art. And so what I did is I took your art and I expanded it
10 feet by 20 feet in the air, made flags, made thousands upon thousands of baseball cards, and I'll leave everybody with this. My goal is to put, and get a sponsor, to put at least 18,000 t-shirts with your art on it with one of my sponsors to the stadium tour. Now, I'm not just doing it once, Jimmy. I'm gonna do it repeatedly, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 times to every stadium in the United States. That's my goal, Jenny. You ready?
Oh, absolutely.
Get ready, give me a high five. We're gonna piece it out right now. Allen Action and the New York State Arts Bank. You heard from Jenny Yip. Allen Action, it's the Bud Fowler Initiative. Peace out.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I worked for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom, and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died that gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause it ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston, from New York to L.A., well, there's pride in every American heart, and I proudly stand and say that I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died and gave that right to me, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA, and I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today. 'Cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. Together. God bless the USA.
Yeah, Mr. D-Dubb, thank you. Hello, my friends. We have a packed house here tonight in the land of our dreams. But we have some nice people here. Family and friends, thank you for coming from Waterbury, Connecticut. Thank you, sir. My gospel ensemble here. You know I have a choir to church right here in Fort Plain. I'd love to see you there in the next few days. I am your host and birthday man, Alan. Say thanks for being with me to celebrate my birthday here in Fort Plain, New York. We have music. We have dance, we have comedy, and of course we have live musicians. Without any further delay, I want to bring someone real special to me. And this man is an amazing comedian, producer, compatriot in the theater with me. We produced a Broadway show together called Wildfire Dogs, the story about Marilyn Monroe right here, interacting with our two husbands, Arthur Miller, and of course, who's the other husband? Joe DiMaggio, right here. It's pretty amazing that we have all these famous people. I hope you can really focus your attention on a few of these amazing people here on the flags. They're icons of baseball and icons of entertainment. And this man with me, who I'm going to introduce in the next few seconds, produced so many great films in the 2000s, the 90s. He did a great stand with MTV. He's a great stand-up comedian and a great guy. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Sean Lynch.
Oh, yeah. Happy birthday. All right. Oh, man. This is,
I was just saying to a buddy of mine, I'm about to travel about four hours up, to upstate New York to do a show. He's like, "What are you doing it for?" I'm like, "A legend."
Yeah, that's right.
Because the world isn't making any more Allen Actions. Like this man is clearly a legend. The thing that, I had a dream. I had a dream the other night about you. I had a dream that you took over for St. Peter in heaven. which was amazing. I just love the idea of Alan standing at the pearly gates of heaven being like, hey, Marilyn Monroe, you got a beautiful figure. All right, come on through. I love your films. You're great. Okay. All right, here we go. Joe DiMaggio, you were one of the greatest ball players ever. I know you had a bit of a drinking problem, but that's okay. Okay, you get in too. All right, Adolf Hitler, buddy, I'd like to let you in, but I'm very sorry. I can't. Member of the 12 tribes, I can't allow it. I'm going to send you someplace warm. Not hell, I'm going to send you to Boca Raton, where you could be a waiter right now in a Yiddish deli. I feel that's what you deserve. It's, first of all, before we get on with this, I want to give a round of applause, A, for you, the audience, and B, for a lot of our performers tonight, for performing through and performing after the pandemic. Because I will tell you, that was one of the hardest things for a lot of us performers to get through. Because during that time, there was no live entertainment in New York City. There wasn't a lot of stuff going on. What there was guys like Alan who were still producing shows, producing comedy shows, producing music shows, fashion shows. One of my plays, when everybody thought, oh, no, it's dangerous, let's not do this. But, you know, when you get the kind of courage that this guy does, you just say, oh, the hell with it, and you do it. That's why a lot of us are here. It's because of that. It's because of that courage, which I gotta say, I admire. You know, he does, man. Alan's from that generation. It's like my dad. It's like that generation of courage that just didn't care. I realized that I'm not gonna get an iPhone app about alcoholism, but these iPhones really are little miracles, and why not use them to their best advantage? They have cameras in them. They record. They can go on the internet. So I decided I was going to do sort of a Jane Goodall documentary about my partying with other comedians. So one night I go out with a bunch of my friends, I take my phone, I put it on video record, and I program it to only record the first minute of every hour. And for 13 hours, we raged it in New York City. And the next day, I saw the saddest 13-minute documentary I've ever seen in my time. It was like HBO presents Where Are My Pants, the Sean Lynch story. It was crazy. And Siri actually narrated the documentary. I didn't program it, just program it that way. And you know Siri, that pretentious bitch that lives in your iPhone? You're like, hey, where's a good Irish bar in Fort Plains? She's like, why don't you go to a gym, fat ass? We married? But so the next day, I'm playing this video that the iPhone recorded, and it's literally like, Sean Lynch, hour one.
Hey dudes, I'm just gonna have one or two more Miller Lights, one more shot, Jameson. Let's go back to the hotel, we got three more shows this weekend. Let's just behave ourselves, okay?
Hour two.
Sweet Caroline, ba ba ba.
Hour three.
Hey, you guys are so forgotten, what? He's a musician, he's a comedian, he's dead. We're all on TV. Everybody got around.
Hour four.
I'll fight all you dudes! Stop making fun of the Knicks. They're doing the backstage. I know karate. I'll take all you guys outside right now.
Hour five.
And she never called me back, bro. She never even texted me a poop emoji, bro. I loved her, man.
Hour seven.
Baby! 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 I just got one question for you. What? I got one question for you. And then I might be your life forever. Okay?
Shut up.
Okay? One question. Could I have a Big Mac and two loaves of fresh pop? You want to make out? It's my birthday. Yeah,
like... Hour nine. This is an Amtrak to Ontario.
You ever do that? You ever fall asleep on a train, plane, or automobile? Boy, that's a weird experience. I had that happen once in Boston. You know, you have the cop coming over and he's like, sir, 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 where are your pants? You got ID? You got ID? And I turned to the cop and I was like, hey, Good evening, officer. Wow. You been drinking?
Yes.
Oh, one or two. One or two what?
One or two kegs, officer. About
hour 11. Turn to the right. Turn to the left. Curtsy. Jazz hands.
Wow.
Sergeant, I didn't know Drew Carey was that talented.
Yeah, I'll make him prison if they don't rape him.
Hour 23. Oh, you won't like this bit.
One at a time, fellas.
I'm not a machine. Some of us need a little romance. What am I trying to say, folks? I'm trying to say I'm dating again. I'm just kidding. What I'm trying to say is happy birthday, Alan. It is a pleasure being here doing this show, and it is a pleasure being here in Albany. You are the best. You are the guy.
Oh, yeah. This is Sean Lynch, everybody. Let's give a nice round of applause. Sean Lynch, great comedian, producer, filmmaker, writer, fantastic. This is Sean Lynch.
Well, action is my middle name, and I'm here at the New York State Arts Bank with some lovely models of Xcari fashion. I want to make sure I get this right. It's Xcarii fashion, but you can see it on the shop. Where?
Xcari.shop.
Right, so it's Xcarii.shop. .shop. Now, let's talk about this brand. The brand is incredible. Molly's actually wearing an amazing, very inexpensive dress, but it looks a lot more than the value of the actual dress costs. So, here's the bottom line, Mr. Xcari, and this is Archie, by the way, the owner of Xcari. Tell us what your brand's about real quick and what your focus is in less than 30 seconds.
Casual, club, comfort. That's what we focus on. We try to bring mainstream fashion to the everyday person. We do vibrant colors. We do vibrant styles. Stuff that'll grab your attention, like this leather-like dress right you see here.
It's incredible. Leather. It's mimicking the leather. It looks like leather, but it costs one-tenth the price.
Exactly.
This is very good. So, you know, it's the visualization of what happens, and you look great, Molly. You look great. And a great dancer, too. What I like about all these girls, including our model here, Giselle, Molly, and, of course, multi-talented Jenny Yip, the outfits fit on their bodies incredibly well, and they're not expensive. What's the average price of the Xcari brand?
I would say about $50, something like that in that area. But of course, we can go, like, for example, when you see us at the New York Fashion Week, which is coming up September 8th through 10th at the Gotham Hall New York Fashion Week, Times Square. We're going to be on one of the dresses on display is a pure silk dress. Pure
incredible.
Silk. 100% silk. That dress is retailing for $260, but it's pure silk.
Yeah, but if probably you hit another designer, it would be $3,000 to $4,000.
That's right.
Here's the bottom line. You got to see what's happening. I do these fashion shows with this brand, and it's an amazing brand. It's affordable. It looks good. Women want it, and you're going to see it at the next fashion show at Gotham Hall in New York City. You've seen it at Sony Music Hall. Now you can see it at Gotham Hall. And you know something? You've seen it also in Miami Swimsuit. And that's swimsuit week, that's swimsuit fashion week, which is pretty incredible.
Yeah,
so
we were down there for Miami Swim Week. At the Hard Rock Casino in Hollywood, Florida, the Guitar Shaped Hotel. And then a week later, we did the Orlando Swim Week.
Incredible. So, you know, there's a lot of shows coming up, but this brand's viable, cost effective. It's inexpensive for the quality, the great quality that it does have.
Most designers, they use the cut and sew method.
Okay.
But in order to keep on top of the trends, keep on top of the latest colors, quick changes, I use a method. We go digitally, we do our designs.
Well, basically, it's quicker, it's faster, it's less expensive, and you have a great result.
And if we want to make a change, I can just go on the computer and just cut and paste a color, and bam.
Fantastic.
Like, if I want to change this color right here, just cut and paste a different color.
Great. Alan Action at the New York State Arts Bank, along with beautiful models, Giselle, Molly, and Jenny, once again at the New York State Arts Bank in Fort Plain, New York. Yes, it's 3 hours away, but only 120 miles from New York City, with the power to market across the world. Peace out, everybody, from the land of Alan Action.
partners fall, and together we made it on. And though my fear is real, my faith in you is true. So together, side by side, we'll see it through. Together, side by side.
Give this man a nice round of applause, Mr. Matt Lajouet. Give a nice round of applause, everybody. Matt Lajouet's here for us.
Happy birthday, Alan, by the way.
Yeah. Ooh, all right.
Yeah, 60.
Yeah. 60?
60
years old.
We're the old.
You don't look a day over 35.
All right. Thanks a lot, guys. This one's an original. Alan requested this. This one's pictures of you.
Pictures of you.
Imagine seeing this dude in front of 52,000 people at Yankee Stadium. That's what I'm talking about.
All right!
Well, right now, what we do have, and he's in the books with this, he's ready to get on the TV show on the MNN Network, Allen Action Man on the Move. You can see him on Verizon. You can see him on Spectrum, streaming, all the other networks. What we want to do, so you understand, the stadium tour, is this dude right here with those T-shirts, with a corporate sponsor, with the D-Dubb experience, with Matt LaJoie, with SE Static, and try at least four stadiums in New York City, Citi Field, Yankee Stadium, and then the 2 Mile League Stadium.
Okay, can we change the atmosphere just a little bit and give God a great round of applause?
Yeah.
Here we go. A cappella, that is. Lord, if I found favor in your sight, Lord, Lord, please hear my heart's cry. I'm desperately waiting to be where you are. I'll cross the hottest desert, travel near or far for your glory. I will do anything just to see you, Lord.
My vision is to find a goal, the greatest of all time rap writer or singer or lyricist who can help me. And they said, that's a nice idea. It's a nice idea, but listen, we're busy right now. And then I came across the next man I'm gonna introduce you to. And this man was like, baseball? First black American baseball player? All right, this sounds interesting. Tell me about it. And he was listening to me. And I said, you know something? This is something special to me. I had the bank already here. I had the directive of getting this man into the Hall of Fame. He wasn't in the Hall of Fame yet. It was an idea. And he said, you know something, I love baseball. And we started talking about baseball. And baseball linked us, and he played for the Fordham Rams in Fordham College. And we started talking more. And then he believed in the idea. We came up with a great song that I loved, I Want to Thank You, from Alicia Myers, which is a gospel singer. And Alicia Myers and Kevin McCord combined for a hit in 1981. It was a big hit called I Want to Thank You, which is about the Lord and the message of the Lord. And you know something? I said, let's use that song. He said, I like it. I said, I want you to do the lyrics. He said, I got it. And we came up with the first song, Showed the Way, Bud Fowler. And that song was the message of the Hall of Fame. When I said, guys, I want this man in the Hall of Fame. And they said, sir, you're calling too much. Stop calling. And I said, again, 2 o'clock and 4 o'clock, expect my phone call. And I kept doing it until one of my friends in the New York Times said, look, you've got the right message, but your path is a little askew. Do something special that's newsworthy and get this man his due, and you will get publicity and a response. And that's what we did. Manly Baker and myself, the caretaker of the bank, we went down deep into this bank, took out a piece of marble, lifted it up, and made a memorial for Bud Fowler. And it's outside, you can see it right now. And they said, what are you doing? You're taking matters into your own hands. And I said, yes, Hall of Fame, I am. And the New York Times did an article. 7 months later, we got a phone call. Mr. Allen, we have good news for you. The elders have been convened, and we're thinking about putting him in the Hall of Fame. I said, that's better than no.
Yep.
Let's try a yes possibility.
Yeah.
2 months later, they said, congratulations, Mr. Allen, because of your due diligence and your efforts and the efforts of Major League Baseball and the Elders Committee, we are putting him in the Hall of Fame. Without further delay, let's bring this great artist up, Mr. S.C. Static. Give him a round of applause.
Thank you, Alan. Happy birthday. And yeah, he pretty much just went into detail about the whole story. But when I met him, I thought he was kind of crazy and didn't know what he was talking about. As we all can relate to that. But he had so much truth to that story, and it's unfortunate that nobody knows who Bud Fowler is still. But as a baseball person, I mean, growing up, my favorite player was Willie Mays, based on my dad and what he taught me about baseball. That just shows the kind of like house I grew up in. So I feel like it's only right that I wrote this song, because I'm such a hip-hop head and a student of the culture and a student of baseball's culture. And this song was Alan Ashton's idea. He's like the executive producer of it. I had my homie flip the sample by Alicia Myers. It's called Show the Way. All right, yeah. Yo, Bud Fowler dealt with enough doubters, wondering how we handle corrupt power. That's why we gotta give credit in every props to him, cause the first black player wasn't Jackie Robinson. Did you know that? Neither did I. Turns out this whole time, we believed in a lie for so long. That's why we're doing this song, because of what he's overcome, and the truth is his wrong. Yo, for the hope you gave, and the road that you paved, for the bones and brains, for the souls you saved, it's a shame that your story's never told in praise. Yeah, for the hope you gave, and the road that you paved, for the bones and brains. So we chose today to bestow how you played, cause you showed the way. Cause he deserves all the acknowledgement and homage. A prophet that we left over his accomplishments forgotten. Bud Fowler, born John W. Jackson. In Fort Wayne, New York, is still what happened. 1878, he went to the majors. First African-American professional play in May 17th. For the Live Oaks against Ontario at only 20 years old. Yo, for the hope you gave, and the road that you paved, for the bones and brains. For the souls you saved, it's a shame that your story's never told in praise. Yeah, for the hope you gave, and the road that you paved, for the bones and brains. Yeah, so we chose today to bestow how you played, cause you showed the way. From town to town and the bounce around, all because the skin that's under his brow is brown. But never found a frown or get down and now, cause on the mound he just sound and go pound for pound. With any professional will put in games to excel, both as a pitcher and position player as well. But yet it never seems to lower his self-esteem, and ended up playing in over 2,000 teams. Ontario, New Orleans, managed played with separate teams of 70 states from Maine to Texas. Was not to mention how a Dolphin gets every day faced with awful taunts and threats, respected but rejected because the threat by his essence, objected to his presence and eventually protested, and treated as a being equal again. 1881 dropped before the season began. Forfeiters and sinners who act bitter, cause they'd rather be acquitted than lose to a black pitcher. And that's just a little glimpse of what he's been through. Damn, imagine if there would've been you. Never deferred, always worked to persevere through the worst that he's endeared to a 30-year career. Yo, for the hope you gave, and the road that you paved, for the bones and brains. Yeah, for the souls you saved, it's a shame that your story's never told in praise. Yo, for the hope you gave, and the road that you paved, for the bones and brains. So we chose today to bestow how you play, cause you showed the way. For being mistreated, even fine with fees, and spending time in a Negro or minor leagues with white players like a Fowler and a kind of refusing to participate with Fowler in the lineup. Instead of bridging, is giving his mind raised. The same year, won four straight games in 5 days, was paved the way. Not much later, there will be an 87 of the 7 color players in the league, from Moses Fleetwood, Walker to Frank Grant. That's when segregation and taking a plain stance drew a color line, added hatred and deceit, unofficially banning all color players from the league. Then out of necessity, made it his dream to manage his own black pro baseball team, the pace bench giants who would play with the pros, and end up winning 82 straight games in a row to blatantly show they clearly could compete with each other. Never do this through the lack of certain media coverage, and this persisted for 50 years. Unbeknownst, but for most, it could bring to tears. But through the pain, he uncovered the lane, which others have came and did it for the love of the game. Yeah, just to show that your shade of skin shouldn't matter if you're great and you play to win. Yeah, yo, for the hope you gave, and the road that you paid, for the bones and brains. For the souls you saved, it's a shame that your story's never told for praise. Yo, for the hope you gave, and the road that you paid, for the bones and brains. So we chose today to bestow how you play, cause you showed the way. Thank you, thank you. Yeah, Mr. Nelson, Bud Fowler. Do your research, man. And that's with many things in life. Like, the first person is usually not credited. There's usually a lot of people that laid the foundation for the quote-unquote first. And he's just one of many. This next track is brand new, off my new album. The song's called Embrace Your Weirdness. And I think I have some ladies who can join me on stage. Can you turn that beat up a little bit? It's called About Self-Love. Check it out, yo.
Started?
Yep.
All right, cool.
Get ready, girls.
All right, this song's off my next album
called Love Me Is This. The whole album is basically about just like me embracing who I am fully. A lot of people tell me I gotta do this, I gotta do this, you gotta sound like this, this. It's like, no, I am this, and this is what it is. Love Me Is This, or just listen to somebody else. And this song's called Embrace Your Weirdness, because I'm kind of a weird dude, I have a quirky sense of humor. I have a lot of serious, deep songs, but I like to have fun too. And we have not rehearsed this, so we're just kind of improvising with the dance, so I appreciate them joining me on this journey. This is the first time I performed this song too, live, so I hope you enjoy it. Check it out. Yeah, being that, we all got like unique characteristics and traits that make us all different. I figured it's only right we embrace self-love. Yo, I'm not ashamed and I won't bother to get it, but some of my traits you wouldn't want to borrow would get it. Yo, and even though he doesn't want all the credit, anything that's strange about me, blame my father's genetics. Yo, some get acne, others get bad knees, because my dad's jeans got one hell of a pair of flat feet. No curve in the arch on my flat foot, at the beach looking mad shook. It's a bad book, embracing it, just comedy, dude. How am I being true, just to try to be cool, cause I've learned to expect less and express more, and everyone's approval I ain't holding my breath for. So I suggest that you lace your sneakers, cause the best offense in this game is deep. We're all the same, but contained in each us, with different strengths, weaknesses, traits, and features. So hopefully on the day that you hear this, you relate, cause you can't fake sincereness. Be yourself and go from afraid to fearless. No longer ashamed, then embrace your weirdness. And I'll admit, people bliss has been pain, pissed on my name and dismissed as insane. So I may be perceived as crazy, cause I mean what I say, and I'm freaky, baby. Conservative people may hate and behave, like maybe you would make a mistake, but playing it safe, because excitement is only during my risk. Cause what can be considered normal in a world like this. So let yourself free and engage the beast, and embrace your deep traits for the sake of peace. So bring the flavors and taste the pain, just say hey to your neighbors, embrace the strangers like. So I suggest that you lace your sneakers, cause the best offense in this game is defense. We're all the same but contained in each us, the different strengths, weaknesses, traits and features. So hopefully on the day that you hear this, you relate cause you can't fake sincereness. Be yourself and go from afraid to fearless. No longer ashamed and embrace your weirdness. Then bounce back to detach from the stigma and doubt that you can match the charisma, the break from the shame, the sad frown, the shake what your grandmama gave to pass down. Like wow, everybody's staring at him now, still rocking hand-me-downs, but I wear them like a crown. That's my style, really they don't like me, but say they do is what I could become or what I might be. So likely I'll still be at the best school, receiving fresh fuel from my nieces and nephews. I stayed true and gave my pain to the public, unadulterated funk, and you can hate it or love it. So come on, so I suggest that you lace your sneakers. The best offense in this game is defense. We're all the same but contained in each other, different strengths, weaknesses, traits and features. So hopefully on the day that you hear this, you relate cause you can't fake sincereness. Be yourself and go from afraid to fearless. No longer ashamed and embrace your weirdness. Then stop, then go, and then drop, and just flow, check it out. Yo, go, 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 come on, come on. And yo, bounce back to detach from the stigma and tap that you can match the charisma, the break from the shame, the sad frown, and shake what your great-grandma gave to pass down. So I suggest that you lace your sneakers, cause the best offense in this game is defense. We're all the same, but contained in each us, different strengths, weaknesses, traits, and features. So hopefully on the day that you hear this, you relate, cause you can't fake sincereness. Be yourself and go from afraid to fearless. No longer ashamed and embrace your weirdness. Like, it's like that. Yeah, put you on the track. Hell yeah. Now show me what you got. Come on, go, 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 Alan. It's your birthday. Go, Alan. Go and work it. And then stop. Tap to the dash from the stigma and tell that you can match the charisma to break from the shame and sad frown and shake what your great grandma gave to pass down. Best offense in this game is defense. We're all the same but contained in each other, the different strengths, weaknesses, traits and features. So hopefully on the day that you hear this, you relate cause you can't fake sincereness. Be yourself and go from afraid to fearless. No longer ashamed and embrace your weirdness. Yeah. It's like that. Who cares about what other people think, man? That's basically the gist. You know what I'm saying? Be yourself. Word up. Peace, 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 the peace, peace. Shout out to Alan Action. Happy birthday. Thank you, girls, for joining me. I appreciate that. This song is called Freaking the Funk Out. Actually, just a little backstory for this song. I really only been in one real relationship in my life. And I dated her like twice on and off. And then the last time I saw her, she, for whatever reason,
just threatened me with a restraining order. Like, she was going to call the cops and get a restraining order on me. I shouldn't even be sharing that. But I was so, I didn't know what to do with this emotion. I was like, this girl's crazy, man. This girl's crazy. I don't deserve to be treated that way. You know what I mean? Honestly, I don't. And I wrote this song, and I feel like it's the most positive, funky, optimistic thing I could have done after that moment, because I really wanted to, you know, I was not feeling good. But I turned it into something I think that everyone can relate to. Or hopefully not. Hopefully you can't relate to it. But I feel like most people can. And this is called Freaking the Funk Out, and it's me just like losing it. But like in a, I channeled it though, and here it is. Check it out.
They tried to call it a comeback, but I've been doing this since day one. Wrote about 100,000 lyrics to the same drum. Going about a different route, but Loki's all the way done. And never running or forgotten where I came from. That's why my dreams became true while you made fun. We're all under the same moon and the same sun. And with that effort, you'll be waiting forever. So take the pain with the pleasure of making change for the better. Yeah, let's pass out to lose control in your hands. And watch me pull you with it because I don't know how to dance. Yeah, with both shirt sleeves ready to bust out. Going A-ball, then I'm freaking the funk out. Taking up the ground, so I'm cold within myself. Don't be close up on the shelf, cause I'm whole within myself. Roll another L to the wax of the dish shop. No need to make it pop, cause you have it at hip hop. It could be feeling what the feeling and that groove that. You know they come in static when you're feeding for some boom bad. And even though I'm not a popular feature, follow the leader, and if not, at least acknowledge the teacher. If you ain't been in August, KRS and Rockin, who without them you wouldn't even have a top 10. Here's a brand new release, the streets need. But lost without rap, but these beats complete me. As fast out, I'll lose control in your hands. So watch me book you with it, because I don't know what it is. Yeah, they go and scream loud, deep as your lungs shout. Going A-wall, then I'm freaking the funk out. Cause she's the prettiest girl in this town. So to cope with it now, all I do is refer to the sound. Now put your hands up, if you're feeling hurt or the down. Put your fingers at your head and go and twirl them around. Like, son of a donkey, this chick, she haunts me. I gotta shake it off me, like chick, get off me. If you feel like stress, go and give a shout. Take your regression, just build it up and let it out. Like death or the BS, lately I've been stressed. Everybody throw a fit, crazy as your ex. Now put him up insane in the light bulb. It's already nuts, but the chick made me a psycho. I spazzed out to lose control in your hands. Watch me boogie with it because I don't know how to dance. Yeah, then go and scream loud, deep as your lungs shout. Go and A-ball, then I'm freaking the funk out. So go and set it when it begins a dumb impression. Let him fix him or contest him. I'm a ripping drunk and headed. I'm ripping up in seconds with a ridiculous fucking pressure. Put him a spin is uncontested. Put him a ticket, I'm so checking. F or the B, yes, lately I'm in stress. Everybody throw up in crazy as your ex. Put him up insane in the light bulb. It's already dust, but that chick may be a psycho. Before I'm placing directional facilities, better start respecting my professional abilities. Broken hearted and went on a shroomy shroom pin. Travel to the moon and I've been a moony tune since. Spazz out and lose control in your hands. Watch me book you in a knee cause I don't know how to dance. Yeah, they go and scream loud, deep as your lungs shout. Go and aim ball and I'm freaking the funk out. Yeah. Yeah. It's like that, I mean. What else could I do? Spazz out. Be on the lookout, new music coming soon. My name is Essie Static. We're here for Alan Action, we're here for Buck Fowler. We're here for everybody in the building. Yeah, shout out to D-Dubb. Shout out to my dancers behind me. Sean Lynch in the building. Shout out to my man Matt Hill, the guitar. Yeah. Shout out to Kuya off the beats, man. These beats are ill.
Shake that. Yeah, you see, this is really, really simple stuff. We call this Ready to Wear. Very simple, easily washable, ready to go out, bam, it's on, and you know, bam, it could be off. But it is beautiful stuff. This is Xcari, X-C-A-R-I-I. Check it out on your phone, Xcari. Oh, I like this girl. This girl is gorgeous, all the way from overseas, born in Sweden. Put your hands together for beautiful Molly, everybody. Molly. Molly's beautiful. Hold on, what's going on here? This girl can dance too, right? Really good. We're going to come back to that later on. Give Molly a nice round of applause, Holly. I got you, Molly. Watch your step, honey. Keep it going. Now.
is a wonderful woman with many talents. Professional artist, model, great businesswoman, and a tremendous hip-hop dancer. And guess what? She is a little over 21, in case you want to know. Jenny Yip is an amazing woman all the way from the state of Hong Kong to New York. Her whole life. Give Jenny Yip a nice round of applause. Yeah, once again, beautiful Giselle, otherwise known as Heavenly Rose. Give her a nice round of applause. Better get some love insurance for Tula. Very interesting assignment. Thank you. The more I get, the more that I want is Tulip. Otherwise known as Heavenly Rose. Fantastic. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for Mr. Archie Phillips, the art designer. Oh yeah. This is Excali Fashion. Fantastic. Mr. Archie again. Thank you for being with us. Once again, in case you want to go on their fan club, our media right, raise your hand right now. That's Giselle, otherwise known as Heavenly Rose. Show us your hand so they know who you are. That's beautiful Jenny Yip, our designer of the Bud Fowler. And that's Mr. Archie from Excari. Holly Hagerman, our beautiful dancer, bartender, and of course, Tulip from Sunnington, Connecticut. Fantastic. We love it. Amazing. This is Excari Fashion. Thank you for being here for my birthday party. It's fantastic to be here with you.
Happy birthday, Alan. On behalf of everybody, on behalf of every artist that you've ever worked with, and every person that came out here to let you know that we love you and that we believe in you, happy birthday. And I gotta say, I was very moved by your story about your dog, Max. And in addition to being moved by the story of Max, I thought the best thing about that story is it captures two things. It captures who you are as a human being, and it captures your relationship to every artist you come across. Because that's what you do. You find people that are special, and maybe people that are in a little bit of need, and that may not have the same breaks as the rest of us, and you see something special in them, and you push, and you try, and you give them life. And however long that life is, you make it better. And if there's any better testimony to a human life, it's that you made every life and every person you came across better. And you do that. That's your gift to us. And so this happy birthday is our gift to you. You're a good dude, man. I'm glad we're friends.